is dan line rate. En on the bottom, things are getting slower. This is the whole idea of this device. So we looked at devices that are being made, and we came out to what is now made by Four Standard Works, the MTP-10G card. That's a network interface card, which is actually part of a security system. And that security system is to do intrusion detection on 10 gigabit internet, also do prevention, so block traffic that you don't want on 10 gigabit internet. And this card is all built around programmable hardware. And this programmable hardware, that has a nice feature that you can make your own software for it. And that's what we did. So let's just have a look at how this card is being built. It's actually built around three main programmable devices. And on the top, we have what we call the front-end FPGA. And in the front-end FPGA, there is this repeater, where we repeat the traffic between the two interfaces. The card has so-called XPEC interfaces. This is here are the interfaces, and this is the front-end FPGA. XPEC is one of the form factors, transceiver form factors of 10 gigabit Ethernet. So traffic is being copied between these two transceivers and being copied down over this bus towards the block below. And what is going over that link, over these errors, that are 128-bit wide blocks of data. And the first block contains the whole Ethernet frame, including its preamble. A preamble is something that was used in 10 megabit Ethernet to clock the frames. 10 gigabit doesn't do that anymore, but the makers of IEEE decided to make it completely the same as the old 10 gigabit, the old 10 megabit Ethernet and 100 megabit and gigabit Ethernet. So it has this preamble. Then it is followed by the destination MAC, and then you have a little bit room left, 16 bits. And that's where the source frame starts. And then, once this is on the bus, there is a second word which contains the rest of your data, or the rest of the 128 bit of your data, and a third word, and it goes on, and goes on, until you reach the end of the frame. And then you get the next frame. And that's ending up at the backend FPGA. And the backend FPGA is really the heart of this whole system, because that is where we filter the traffic, where we reduce the data rate. So how do we do that? Traffic is being, this 128-bit is being received in a frame data register, 128 bits. And then we really have to process it. And that processing, that is something that you have to do fast. And actually there is a trick for that. Is to process this whole 128 bits all at once with different processors. So we have an array of processors that can be applied on this 128 bits all at once. They have a register, instructions to get the instructions. The data is being processed and then being reduced into what I call reduction network, and that results in one or a zero. Should this data be copied to the PC or should it not be copied to the PC? If it should be copied, then the match memory, where all the 128 bit words altogether are being stored, if that matches, then it goes to the PCI Express and to the PC. So this is a pretty straightforward concept. The really, really tricky here is that you have one single register of data and lots of processors that process it all at once. Because you have not too much time to process it. You cannot make a whole decision tree to decide what you want, which is basically what you do with a normal processor if you program in a sequential language. So that was, in a real overview, the hardware. Which is a different drawing. That's here below. That was the hardware. And we need to make some software on top of it. So the software consists of two kernel modules. The software is made for Linux. On the right side, a kernel module that is basically the Ethernet driver. It acts like a normal Ethernet driver and presents the card as a normal Ethernet interface to the user. And that normal interface, you can just use your normal hardware, your normal software on it. And there's another kernel module that takes a piece of memory, and from that you can control the card. And that's the input and output. For the output, there's just a polar reading out counter values, and give that to some output. And on the input, that's a bit more difficult. So let's have a look at the input. On the input, it takes, and you might have seen that already in the demo, it just takes from standard in the filter expressions that are used in used by libpcap, like not ether source and then MAC address. This being processed by a lexer in a parser, very, very straightforward. Many programs work like that. And that actually recognizes the addresses and recognize the operators and transfers that into some kind of internal expression. What is being done is the data is being taken. So you have a pattern of data. You have an offset in your frame you want to match, and that those are being matched together and being treated as one variable. And this is being stored internally, and then processed by the Quinn-McCluskey algorithm, or QM algorithm, which is a fairly well known, if you are into this, algorithm that changes this expression to what is called its disjunctive normal form, its sum of products. And this is really important because, remember, we had all these little processors all working together. That means that, and all working all together, all at once. That means that you have to cut your expression into different pieces. And this is really key in this whole system. Once you have it in this distributive normal form, or this sum of products, then it's really easy. Then it's just a matter of getting it into the registers. Well, that's being done by a module called the register mapper. And that just takes this distinctive normal form and puts it into the instructions that are being, that are recognizable for the FPGA. So this is an overview of the system. Any questions about that? There is a hand, I think.
How do you cope with VLAN tags and IP options changing the header length?
Yeah, that's a very good question. Not yet. I have an idea on how to do that. Is that you use some of these internal processors to recognize, let's say, a VLAN tag, and say, okay, I have to shift everything I got, I have to add a certain number of bits to it. That's how you can work with shifts in the data that are really, really fixed. for options, especially IPv6 options, yeah, I have to do the same, I guess, to do that. IPv6 is actually easier because you see the, you know, with every frame you get where you have the, with every option you get where you have to add the offset. IPv4 options, I guess I have to hard code those into different, use a number of processors to do that. But yeah, we are a layer 2 network, and it's really, really rare that I have to go that deep in the traffic. That's, I guess, when I need it, we'll program it. That's the idea. So, okay. Any other question? Excellent question, by the way. Okay. I'll go into a little bit more detail on how things are being processed. Let's have this not eater source thing here. Expression, and it's getting its first data word in, and in that first data word there is a little bit of piece of data we want to process, the first 16 bits of this source address. The processors can process per 16 bits, so we need one processor for that. The second word contains the rest of the data we want to process, so we need two processors for that. And what the processor takes is the pattern to match and the offset in the data. And yeah, basically that's what the processor is working with. And it's looking at the data, does it match or does it not match? But then we have a problem with this NOT operator, because this NOT operator is going over the whole data. And I really, really worked on how should I operate this NOT operator, or an operator like that, where you have to process, you have to get a result and then process an operator on it. So first thought, okay, let's make a programmable network behind the processors. But then you actually lose this parallel processing. You make a block behind all the processors that should work on line rate. And how, the more complicated you make this block, the more time it will take to propagate through this block of data. So that will limit the speed, and it also will limit any scalability. And that this was really a problem in designing this whole thing. And then the idea was, so let's try to see if we can transform it in software by making actually a sum of products. You can always do that with Boolean expressions. And it really took me a while to get the term for this, to get it into this disjunctive normal form. But once I found this term, how you describe this form of expression you have, then it was really easy to find an algorithm that does that for you. And this is a QM algorithm. And you have actually libraries you can find on the internet. And then everything was solved. So I can give you a bit more detail on how these registers are working. I had 16 bits. I decided to make 16 bits for the register that, of course, needs to contain a pattern. And well, 16 bits seem to be a nice thing. So the register looks like this. It has a pattern for 16 bits. It has an offset 11 bits. That means that I have, in theory, the option to look all the way through all the bits of a 1522 byte frame. Of course, I need to tell the machine what it needs to do, and that's our 3 bits. And then there are some last bits to handle actually products that are larger than 16 bits. And that's been done by actually chaining